Welcome back to TenorShare, everyone. The new iPhone 15 has arrived. In order to take you guys to experience the new iPhone 15 as soon as possible, I activated it and tried to transfer my old iPhone data to it as soon as I got it. But during the transfer process, I failed several times. It is very frustrating. Got the new iPhone, but you can't transfer your old iPhone data to it. These are the situations I felt when I tried to transfer my old iPhone data to my new iPhone. The first one is a little weird. I tried to use the Quick Start feature, which is the iPhone made for transferring data between iPhones. After I began the Quick Start and continued with the process, I found out my iPhone 15 reached the App and Data page. You can see the Quick Start page shows up again if you tap Transfer from iPhone. But I already began the Quick Start process at the beginning. This makes no sense. And if I continue the process, I will get to the home page, but there is no data at all. None of my old iPhone data is transferred to my new iPhone. This means I never begin the Quick Start process, it's not working. If I use the Quick Start feature a second time in the process, it will stuck on this circle forever. If you use the Quick Start feature a second time, it will become like this, so just restart your iPhone. So I force restarted my iPhone and tried to use the Quick Start feature again. This time at the very beginning, after connected to Wi-Fi, the iPhone 15 Pro tries to activate. It shows unable to activate. And I tried it again. This time at the Apple ID login page, it shows verification failed. Then I tried it again. This time, everything looks fine, and then when prepared to transfer, it shows data transfer canceled. Honestly, this really makes me tired. So I tried it last time, and this time when both iPhone try to connect to each other, which is the Getting Things Ready page, it took me forever. And then, my iPhone 15 just went straight back to the language settings page. So I checked it out, and I found out Apple just released a new update of iOS 17. The update says, fix an issue that may prevent transferring data directly from another iPhone during setup. Okay, it means the iPhone 15 came out with the buggy iOS 17.0 that will cause iPhone data transfer fail. Well done, Apple. Never expected the iPhone 15 will come out with the iOS that is not the latest one. This means if we don't update our iPhone 15 to the latest one of iOS, the transfer.95% will fail again. But before we start the upgrade, if you want to give it another try, you need to make sure the condition below is fulfilled. First, make sure your Wi-Fi is in good condition, the signal is strong and the network is working. Second, make sure your both iPhone is fully charged, at least 50% power. If don't, just charge it while transferring. Then you can try the Quick Start feature again, but this time, if you see the software update page, make sure you tap Update Now, so that your iPhone 15 will update to the latest iOS that has fixed the transfer issue. But again, my update failed, so I will try another way. I use a professional Apple device's system repair and iOS upgrade, downgrade tool called Reboot. I already put the link in the description. You can upgrade your iPhone while it's not activated, but you also can upgrade your iPhone 15 when it's activated. After upgrading to the latest one, just erase it and restart the activate process. Once installed Reboot, connect your iPhone 15 to your PC or Mac and open Reboot. If Reboot didn't detect your iPhone 15, you need to put it in recovery mode. Now click the iOS upgrade option, choose upgrade and click initiating upgrade. You can see Reboot detects the new iOS 17.02, which is the one used to fix the transfer data bug. Click download, the download process won't be long, depending on your network condition. Once the download is finished, click the upgrade option. Then the Reboot will begin the upgrade process, which will take a while. Meanwhile, relax and be patient. Okay, the upgrade process is done. Now let's try the data transfer process again. Start the Quick Start process, scan the circle, connect to Wi-Fi, then at transfer data page tap continue. Log in your Apple ID. Continue the setup, then the data transfer will begin. It took me a while, but the transfer is complete. When the data transfer is okay, your iPhone will restart. Still, there are chances that at the restart process, you will stuck on loading bar or Apple logo. Now we are back to the hello screen. Finish the rest setup. Finally, we get to the home page. You can see my old iPhone apps are here. My old iPhone photos and videos are all showing on my new iPhone 15. What a difficult process, but we made it. Now we can enjoy the action button. Okay, that's all. Hope this video can help you transfer data successfully. If not, please leave a comment and tell me the problem. I will help you as soon as possible. Subscribe to us if you want. See you next time.